Video, the following contents are covered. IO port usage in 8051, special function registers and their use in 8051, pin description of 8051. IO port usage in 8051. As we know, there are four IO ports in 8051, that is port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3. So first, port 0. Port 0, it is from pin 32 to 39. So we have the 8 pins from pin number 32 to 39. Port 0, it is also designated as AD0 to AD7 because it can be used either as address bus or data bus based on the value of ALE, that is address latch enable. So when ALE is 0, it will indicate that P0 is used as data bus, as D0 to D7. And when ALE's value is high, it indicates that P0 is used as address bus A0 to A7. While connecting the 8051 to external memory, port 0 will provide both address and data. By using the same port for both address and data, we can save the pins. So 8051 multiplexes address and data through port 0 to save pins. Next is port 1 and port 2. In 8051 based systems with no external memory connection, both port 1 and port 2 can be used as simple IO ports. Whereas in 8051 based systems with external memory connection, port 2 will be used only as address bus and cannot be used as IO port, whereas port 1 can be used as IO port. So port 2 along with port 0 will be used to provide the 16-bit address for the external memory. Port 0 will provide the lower 8 bits A0 to A7 and port 2 will provide the upper 8 bits A8 to A15. Next is port 3. Port 3, similar to port 1, can be used as IO port, both as input port as well as output port. It doesn't need any pull-up resistors as in the case of port 0. Port 3 also has some additional functions, that is providing some important signals. So from pin number 10 to 17, we have the port 3 IO port. Pin number 10 and 11 is for serial communication, that is receiving and transmission of data serially. Pin number 12 and 13 is for external interrupt. Pin number 14 and 15 is for timer circuit. Pin number 16 and 17 is for external memories, read and write. In 8051, there are some group of registers which for the operation do not use the internal 128 byte RAM address from 00H to 7FH. Instead, they use the address from 80H to FFH. These group of registers are called as special function registers. Some of the special function registers are also bit addressable, as in the case for the bit area of RAM. This feature will allow the programmer to change only what needs to be altered, leaving the remaining bits in the special function register unchanged. Out of the addresses from 80H to FFH, which are used for SFRs, if an address which is not defined or empty is used, it will result in unpredictable address. That is, attempting to use an address which is not defined or empty, it results in unpredictable result. The table shows the special function registers along with their function and internal RAM address. Special function registers in certain opcodes are named by their functional names, such as for accumulator A or for timer 0 higher byte TH0, and also in other opcodes they are referenced by their address, such as for accumulator 0E0H and for timer 0 higher byte 8CH. The address for the special function registers used in the program should start with a number. Hence, the address E0H for the accumulator A begins with 0. So it is 0E0H. If this number convention is not used, then the program will encounter assembler error while it is assembled. This is the pin diagram of 8051. Next, we'll see the pin description. So, pin number 18 and 19, that is XTAL2 and XTAL1. It is the internal oscillator input and output. The 8051 has an on-chip oscillator, but it requires external clock to run it. So, a quartz crystal oscillator will be connected to the input XTAL1, that is pin 19, and XTAL2, pin 18. Also, this quartz crystal oscillator will require two capacitor of value 30 picofarad. So, the connection is shown in the figure. If a frequency source other than crystal oscillator is used, such as a TTL oscillator, it will be connected to XTAL1 and XTAL2 will be left unconnected. The figure shows the connection. The speed of 8051, it refers to the maximum oscillator frequency connected to XTAL. Next is RST, that is reset pin. Normally, the RST pin will be logic 0, that is low, and logic 1 on this pin will disable the microcontroller, that is microcontroller will be reset and it will terminate all its activities. This is often referred as power on reset. Activating power on reset will cause all the values in the registers to be lost. So, the reset pin should be logic 0 for the program execution to start. In order for the reset pin to be effective, it must have minimum duration of 2 machine cycles. That is, the high pulse must be high for a minimum of 2 machine cycles before it is allowed to go low. The table shows the reset value for the different registers in 8051. For program counter and for data pointer, the reset value is 0000. For accumulator, it is 00. For program status word register, it is 00. For stack pointer, it is 07. For register B, it is 00. For input output ports P0 to P3, it is FF. So the first line of source code in ROM location 0 should have the value, reset value 0000. Next is EA, that is external access. It is an input pin and will be connected to either VCC or ground. When 8051 family members is used, which has on-chip ROM to show programs, EA pin will be connected to VCC. And for 8031 and 8032 family members, which don't have on-chip ROM, so the code will be stored on external ROM. Hence, EA pin will be connected to ground, which will indicate that the code is stored externally. Next is PSEN, that is Program Store Enable. It is an output pin. If external ROM is used for storing the program, then PSEN will have logic 0 value. This pin is connected to the OE pin of the ROM. Next is ALE, that is Address Latch Enable. It is also an output pin and is active high. The port 0, it is used both as address bus and data bus based on the value of ALE. When ALE value is high, it means port 0 is used as address bus, and when ALE value is low, it means that port 0 is used as data bus. Next is I/O port pins. The four 8-bit I/O ports, port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, each uses 8 I/O pins. All these ports upon reset will be configured as output, else it will be readily used as input ports. Next is VCC. This pin provides the supply voltage to the chip. The voltage source is plus 5 volt. Next is GND, ground. It is the ground pin.